This is Rachel with Good Behavior Beginnings, and today I wanted to talk about homeschooling over the holidays. So which holidays are certainly going to depend upon what holidays you celebrate, what holidays your family celebrates, and if you're following any sort of traditional school schedule, maybe to match up with peers or siblings that are enrolled in the local school district. But when we come to holiday breaks, I think that there are a few things that we keep in mind when we are making our decisions about what homeschool over the holidays looks like. So one of the things that our family considers is, of course, whether or not we're going to have people visiting. Generally speaking, if we have people visiting, we're not doing any real school activities. We might do some fun hands-on activities, but we're not doing any sort of homeschool during that time because we have company up. If we don't have company up, then we are definitely going to go with less structured times, especially if I'm off work, then I don't want to have to keep the same schedule. So, so we go a little bit less structured, but we still accomplish some of our school routines. What I tend to do is match up our break or our less structured days to be sort of close to what peers might be honoring, depending upon which school system they're in. So a lot of our peers are actually homeschoolers as well, but we do have a few that are in the public school. So we kind of look and see what those dates look like so that we're similar to that. When we go to those less structured days, we're still going to do some of the activities, but maybe we're focusing more on how those activities or those skills generalize into our environment. So we're doing more hands-on activities. So if we've been learning about something in science, then as we approach like a holiday break, we might be planning science experiments that we're going to do during that time. Or if we've been working on fractions in math, now we're going to be looking at recipes where we can use those fractions while we're baking cakes, right? So looking for those generalization opportunities, the opportunity to do more hands-on, to use this skill in sort of real life. Another thing that we do is we definitely try to spend more time on the learner's interests. So if my learner has been super interested in, let's say, dinosaurs lately, then maybe over the holiday break, we do like a mini unit on dinosaurs. So we do the topics that we're covering are special interest topics as opposed to whatever the general curriculum might be. Now, if you already do your units that way, then that's not really much of a difference, but maybe this is a time to do something, a unit that's maybe more specific to the holiday itself. So last year around the winter holidays, we read about multiple different holidays that are celebrated at that time. And we got like a food crate with foods from different countries that are common during that holiday period. And we made those foods and we looked up where they were on the map and we learned a little bit about those countries. And we also got to eat some cool food, right? So that would be an example of sort of a mini unit that's either a special interest or like holiday related specifically. We just got out of Thanksgiving break, and right before Thanksgiving, we learned about what the first Thanksgiving really looked like, and kind of what those factors go into it and why not every Indigenous group wants to celebrate Thanksgiving because it wasn't a great time for them, right? So we just kind of learned about it from a different perspective. Other things that we do or plan to do for our homeschool over the holidays are going to be like field trips, right? So especially if I'm off work, if we have more time where the adults are not working, then we can actually go to places and do things more so in our homeschool than we can when we're also balancing our jobs as well. So field trips to, you know, go and check out some of the things that we've learned about, go to the museum or the zoo the Native Heritage Center, where we can learn more about some of these topics that we've learned about over the last semester, or what we've recently covered, or again, maybe related to those like special interests or holiday specific topics. And then the other thing that I like to do during these holiday breaks is to incorporate some more educational videos. So instead of doing as much reading per se, because my learner definitely views that as more like school related, maybe we watch some videos. So this whole semester, we've been learning about the hero's journey in literature. So I have a list of movies that that our curriculum sort of recommends as like, these are examples. And I have a few that I know that my learner would like that would also fit that model. So over the holiday break, we're gonna watch a few movies that, you know, sort of relate to these things we've talked about, or are the movie version of some of these books that we've read over the last semester, and kind of, you know, see how that compares. So educational videos, the videos of the books that you've just read, that would be other examples of less structured, more fun looking, but still educational and related to the topic. So in general, what we do is we just make it look a little bit less like school if we are still going to be doing some of these activities. And if we are taking days off, we sort of align those with when we might have family visiting or when our peers might be available to hang out because they are also out of school. So let me know what you are doing or what you like to do when you come to holidays, whether you take a break or whether you homeschool through them, or what you change or what you do different. I'd love to hear your ideas. Feel free to share those in the comments below. And thank you so much.